Jared Goff is Fruityos, not Fruityos. It's a generic version.
Ah, got it.
David, one more and we'll go to the paper.
Put your money elsewhere, because it's not happening. I don't want Lamar here.
Go to Chad, Norrisville, 97.1. What's up, Chad?
Hey, Mikey, Rico, thanks for taking the call.
It's a bud.
Mikey, that drop of you going, shut up. Oh, my God. It makes me so happy.
I feel it was taken out of context, but we'll continue.
This Lamar Jackson thing has me losing my mind. Like you said, Mike, we have the best quarterback situation. It doesn't make sense. And I'm listening to some of these calls and kind of listening to what Rico was saying and going, okay, maybe I need to calm down a little. Maybe they're actually doing things the smart way, trying to position this to make it look like they're interested in a quarterback to get Jalen Carter. If that's what they're doing, hey, great. But if they sign Lamar, to me, this is the most SNL thing ever. They have done such a good job with this rebuild. It's so shockingly to me. They've been so tactful and smart, and they've rebuilt this thing quick. They did it in 2 years. I'm stunned at what a great job they've done, considering how bad the Bears rebuild has been. The Lions actually did a good job with the rebuild. They're ready to win, and they're just going to do all of it. And the guys, that team's behind it. I'm going to do one thing, run, and just
shut up! To completing this thing the right way, to upend the apple cart and treat it like a video game.
I thought Chad was going to go all the Dean.
And
we're going to take so-and-so.
Yeah, that's something.
No, I'm sorry.
And it has happened. Do we have that in the system? Tell me we did. That is the greatest update ever delivered on this station in history. It is.
No.
We have it?
No, the greatest update ever. I wasn't here. It was when the horse died. And it started off, he's dead.
That'd be Barbara?
Yes. No, I don't think I have it here, no.
That was the greatest update.
And it has
happened. And it has happened. The Royals.
Okay. That's, you either know what that means or you don't. We'll go to the people. Let's go to, I believe, Paul and Shelby is next. Paulie, what's going on, buddy?
Well, apparently you got to drink a case of Pepsi and Red Bull before you call the show today.
Yeah, a little bit. It's been aggressive. Lamar's got people up in arms. What do you want to do with it?
Well, to be honest with you, if the Lions did this, it would fit the psyche of 2023 perfectly. It would be like living in a cartoon, in all honesty. This is ridiculous, and I mean, it's got to be a smokescreen. I mean, you know, let's take a look at this, fellas. You know, in 2022, the Lions were ranked as the number 5 NFL offense. And Ben Johnson signed on for another year. And now you want to take all this draft capital that you could fill some defensive holes with good, strong, quick, young, cheap talent.
Right.
And you want to throw it all out the window for a run-first quarterback who, by the way, really hasn't won nothing.
Thank you.
And can we agree that Baltimore is a fairly smart organization that actually wins stuff?
Correct again.
Paul, I would say this. Baltimore, like the Steelers, do not keep people around. They are not into loyalty. They get what they want, and they move on. But when I hear people say, like you, well, you know, what has Lamar won? I would then turn around and say, what have the Lions won?
Well, you know, that's very true, but the Lions have had a long, long history of really not knowing what they're doing. And now for the first time since I've been walking the planet, it actually looks like they got some guys that
they do
know what they're doing.
Well, they do. And you know the worst part? Here's what we intended on talking about today. I have said now for weeks, call Arizona, let's move to 3, price certainty, and I get my pick. Now, this is before Jalen Carter, a little bit of legal trouble. I said, whatever Brad Holmes likes, whatever defensive player is there, take him at three. Now, I would take Will Anderson. That's me. Today, Arizona says we're open for business. The number three pick is available. I'm moving up. I'm taking number six. I'm taking a second round pick. I'm going to three. And I'm getting exactly what you talked about. The best defensive player in the draft on a cheap, controllable deal. I'm going to bookend Aiden Hutchinson with, again, Will Anderson. The comp would be Von Miller. And that's how I'm building my team. And instead, look at what we're talking about. Because Chris Burke and these odds and this, it's ridiculous. It's totally ridiculous to me. 5 years, $250 million, full guarantee. I think the owners are colluding. I don't think Sheila is going to be the one to break rank from the ownership elite. And why would I give up all this stuff for a guy who's a bum?
But how much of this also, I do think that the Ravens are just done with it because deep down they have thought over the last 25 months, you would go out and actually get a real agent and not your mother. We're really doing this. They probably hit the point where, you know, this is just beneath us. What are we doing
here?
They're
doing it because they're going to let the market, who will not give him a Deshaun Watson deal, right, is going to open. Look what happened is.
Right, and I think the fact that his mom is saying, no, it's Deshaun or bust.
And the Ravens are
good. It's bust.
Go ahead. Watch what happens next.
We'll see you next year when we bring you back on the franchise tag for 32 minutes.
Basically, it's the person who wants too much money for their home. Well, enjoy living in your current home. Ain't nobody buying it. Here's a fair offer. No, you don't want it? Good. Go ahead. Find the unicorn buyer.
And you did that with 3 minutes and 50 seconds to spare.
He's dead. That's it.
With such enthusiasm.
That was an actual...
Right. I was listening. I was like, wow.
He led an update. Like,
yes.
Let me have that one more time. He's dead. Do you have that actual update?
I'm still looking.
I can't believe that's real. I thought Rico was messing.
No. Barbaro died.
No, it wasn't Barbaro then. Because Les him doing an update here, and so it must have been Medina Spirit.
I remember it.
Had to be Medina Spirit. Got DQ'd. He passed away. I don't know. It was a Baffert horse.
It was a horse.
Shocker. All right. The IRS can take away your peace of mind, hit your wallet. You need a real team of local lawyers. You need Abraham and Rose. Look, a lot of services are just that. They're phone screeners. You don't want that. You need legit reps. This spring, Maurice and Jerry are going to rep their clients before the Supreme Court. And whether it's an IRS collection or audit, civil or criminal, or even the Michigan Department of Treasury, Maurice and Jerry will advocate for you. Bottom line, they've dealt with the IRS for years. They know the playbook. They know how to help fight for you. Visit abrahamandrose.com today or call 248-539-5040. That's 248-539-5040. And you will never have to deal with the IRS again.
97.1 The Ticket.
This report brought to you by Corwell Health. There's a crash and closure, US 23 northbound at Silver Lake Road and Whitmore Lake. Backups are from 8 Mile. You can exit early, take Whitmore Lake Road or Field Crest Drive instead. Also, new crash reported in the left lane of 94 eastbound just before Maross. Corwell Health is the new name for Beaumont because at their core, they're here to help you be well so you can live your healthiest life possible. Whether you want to take a big step in your health or just the next one, Corwell Health is here for you. Learn more at corwellhealth.org. I'm Shel Pena with traffic.
With this money line underdog on the ice. I'm Aaron Hawksworth, here to help you beat the books with BetQL. Minnesota travels to Winnipeg tonight and the Wild are short dogs at plus 105. The Jets are holding on to the final wild card spot in the West, but the BetQL model is looking at this road dog. BetQL has Wild plus 105 on the money line as a five-star best bet. They have Minnesota projected as a significant favorite. I'm Aaron Hawksworth, bet smarter, beat the books. Download the BetQL app today.
It's not easy being the one everyone counts on to keep your operation running, no matter the weather or supply chain hiccup. But we get you, Raymond in Buffalo, Maria in Miami, and Jules in Troy, taking control of everything that's under your control.
motorcycle rider coach and teach other bikers to ride safely. Training costs just $75, and once you've finished it, you can make $30 an hour on average as a coach. So reap some new rewards from your favorite pastime. Become a rider coach. Learn more at michigan.gov/motorcycle.
This is your daily Tiger Spring Training Update, brought to you by Northville Lumber. Here's Jeff Rieger.
New Tiger Nick Paton is off to a great start this spring. The 26-year-old already has two home runs in just six at-bats, including a walk-off against the Orioles earlier this week. Paton came over to the Tigers in the Gregory Soto trade in the offseason. This Tiger Spring Training Update brought to you by Northville Lumber.
Lumber is Michigan's largest Trex decking dealer. Builders, remodelers, and homeowners love to buy more Trex decking and railing for Northville Lumber than anywhere else. Northville Lumber has the best products, the best selection, and the best price. Northville Lumber is the place to buy Trex decking and railing, as low as $1.59 per foot. No one can beat that price. Professional builders and remodelers, no need for special orders. Northville Lumber always keeps it in stock. Call Northville Lumber now at 248-349-0220 or visit northvillelumber.com.
It's all about the championship.
Feel the intensity of Monster Energy AMA Supercross.
It's time to bring the action.
Emotions run high as the world's best motocross riders leave it all on the track. Get a front row seat to the sport's most intense racing, heated rivalries, and the season-long battle for Super Motocross World Championship points. See the world's best racers compete in Monster Energy Supercross Saturday night at Ford Field. Visit supercrosslive.com.
McLaughlin's Home Furnishings, Metro Detroit's quality furniture store's annual winter sale is ending soon. Hurry now and save 25 to 50% off store-wide on quality home furnishings from the best brands at McLaughlin's. The largest collection of quality American-made furniture is only at McLaughlin's. Real furniture made the right way. From Cheryl, Bassett, Bradenton Young, Archbold, and Amish collections on sale now. Visit McLaughlin's Home Furnishings today in Novi, Utica, and Southgate and feel the difference.
In this market, you'll find Fisher Investments is different than other money managers.
Different how? Aren't we all just looking for the hottest stocks?
Nope. We use diversified strategies to position our clients' portfolios for their long-term goals.
You don't just provide cookie-cutter portfolios?
No. We tailor our clients' portfolios to their goals and needs.
But you still sell investments that generate high commissions for you, right?
No, we don't sell commission-based products. We're a fiduciary, the highest standard of care for a financial advisor. It means we're obligated to act in our clients' best interest.
So when do you make more money? Only when your clients make more money?
Yep. We have one transparent management fee structured so we do better when our clients do better.
Sounds like you really look out for your clients.
We do, because our priority is helping them achieve a comfortable retirement. That might be why most of our clients come from other money managers. Visit FisherInvestments.com to find out why investors like you switch to us. Fisher Investments, clearly different money management.
Investments and securities involve the risk of loss.
The Valenti and Rico Show is presented by Femininio Law. Go to GetDavidGetPaid.com.
Let's get to the people. If you're just joining, no, we're not doing like fantasy radio, but somehow, according to Bet Online, the Lions are the betting favorite to land Lamar Jackson. I did not want to exist in this space. I was far more interested in Arizona putting the number three pick on the board. I want to move up and get Will Anderson, and I want to have a fierce pass rush. I want to have Will Anderson on one side and Aiden on the other. But we don't get to do that because of this, what I deem to be nonsense. But let's talk about it. And if you want him, understand the rule, the terms of engagement. He wants a fully guaranteed deal, and you're going to have to give up two first-round picks. I think it's absurd. But for some reason, there are the Lions at 3-1. And of the list of teams, they have the best quarterback situation. They have a better situation than Tampa Bay, than the Colts, than the Jets, than the Pats, than the Titans.
Which leads me to think that the Lions are playing the game.
Maybe so. Maybe they're just doing what you've asked them to do. But the other angle is nobody, and I mean nobody, wanted a part of Lamar yesterday. Every report was who wouldn't force him.
Yeah, it's strange being that he has an MVP.
Or it's not strange.
It's legitimate or not.
Because the owners decided. No, it's legitimate.
45-16 record.
It's
people should be, yeah, they should be lined up for this QB.
Burrow is going to dictate that. Joe Burrow, they could give him every building in downtown. Let me see what Burrow gets. But my answer is probably because the NFL does not want to set precedent. The Browns went rogue when they did that.
Well, I mean, because the last two QBs, well, two out of the last three QBs had that deal of basically Kyler Murray and Watson.
Yep. Let's go to Travis, 97. What's up, Trav? How are you?
Hey, how you doing, man?
Good.
I was calling about the Lamar Jackson situation. My thought about it, I don't know if the owner's trying to collude in. What I think is, if they're playing with Lamar's emotions, he's got to realize he's his own agent. So, you know, he's hearing nobody wants him. Price might come down a little bit. And now you can get Lamar for cheap because now he already knows Baltimore doesn't want him.
Listen, I think the owners are absolutely suppressing the market. I think the owners are as devious and duplicitous, and they will rally around each other to protect the org. They're not going to allow what Cleveland did and make that the new norm. And I just think it's...
I hear you, man. I don't know how close they really are. You see how Snyder was already off the boat. Like, he raised, you know, a trade on him already. So I just think they want to win bad. Owners
want to
win bad more than anything.
Owners want to win. I disagree with you there, Travis. Owners want to be profitable more than anything.
Yeah, if I say money is more important.
I don't think many of these owners care because they're going to make their money regardless.
Yeah, Travis, you probably got 10 owners who will do whatever it takes to win Super Bowls. The other 22, they're just waiting for that billionaire welfare check to kick in.
Also, I want to tell y'all that if we do go for Lamar, we won't be giving up the 6th pick. We'll be giving up the 13th pick. We only can give up our own pick. The 6th pick is from the Rams. So we won't be losing. We still have the opportunity to go get whoever we want.
I understand. It's just, Travis, you're giving up the ability in consecutive years to draft a young, controllable player. You're also going to be forever altering your salary cap. David, pull up the salary cap for me. What is it, 221? That sound about right?
I jumped to 224.
Fine. Yeah, dude.
Fine. David, make it 230 if you want to. I don't care. $50 million to one human on a 53-man roster. And this guy's ability is solely dependent on his athleticism. We just saw this play out. We all knew Cam Newton was a fake. Meaning, oh, he's got an MVP and he meant to the Super Bowl. But Cam Newton's not that good. Cam Newton's body started to break down, and it got to a point where you're like, wait, is Cam really that bad? Like, no one wants him? Yeah, he's that bad. He's terrible.
Yeah, but let me say this, though.
Go ahead, David.
No, you go ahead, Rico.
I would say the difference is Cam Newton, he's going to be, to me, like Jalen Hurts. There's going to be a price to pay lowering your head and running into a line. And even though they do that little rugby scrimmage, it's going to shorten his career. A guy like Lamar Jackson is not taking the hits because you can't catch him. He's running out of bounds. So I get what you're saying. It compares to Cam, but I think Hurts is more comparable to what Cam did.
Yeah, and let me say this, because you just said something there, Mike, and I was thinking. Oh, you're saying, okay, 224, 50 million to one player. But wouldn't this be the team? They don't have any other big contracts.
David.
They can structure it to where you get it over with, and then you can pay your guys.
Yeah, but David, the problem is when you fully guarantee a contract, there's really no way to structure it.
Oh, I know. But here's the detail of what Watson's deal is.
Sure.
Because it's fully guaranteed, every year they can restructure it if they want to. They can change the base salary on it to give themselves room every year.
Kick the can down the road.
Look, David, if this
was... Yeah, because the first year was just a million, right?
Correct.
David, if this was a player I actually liked, I would do it. I would talk about it. But explain to me again. Jared Goff, over the last 24 games, better completion rate, more touchdowns, fewer interceptions, a higher QBR, 1,000 more passing yards. What is this allure? Because he's fun to use in Madden?
No.
Because you like highlights? Let me help you out with this, Mike. And maybe this will bring it home to you. It's why I always used to say, man,
Eli won you two Super Bowls, but you would be like, yeah, but he was this, and he was this, and he was this, and he breathed through his mouth, and all of this other stuff, and it would be like, yeah, but he won you two Super Bowls. That's how the Lions fans feel about Jared Goff. Everything that you're saying is correct, but they're still like, yeah, but he's dead. He's not this person. He can't do this. Right. He can't do that. It's like, yeah, but look at what he's done for you.
You know what's funny? Only one of the quarterbacks in this conversation has been to a Super Bowl. And it's not the one you're trying to hand $250 million to.
Look at that.
Oops.
It's a mic drop.
I got nothing. Well, then, let me tell you about Marambio GMC and Taylor right now. The 23 Acadias, $259 a month. 23 Terrains, $289 a month. Both 24 months, $1,499 down. Well-equipped. If your ride needs service, that's what MoranExpress.com is for, the Certified Service Center. Make the appointment. You get a free loaner. Moran Buick GMC, where you always get the best price, period, on Telegraph, just north of Eureka and Taylor, or MoranExpress.com. It is Moran Buick GMC. We are professional grade.
This is Jim Rome with the CBS Sports Minute. Listen, credit where credit is due. On a night where former Laker great Pau Gasol got his number retired, the purple and gold Titanic did not wreck his moment and ruin the night. In fact, another big man saw to it. Much maligned Anthony Davis stepped up and had another 30 and 20 game. I'm Jim Rome.
Ray Maliotta here for eBay Motors. Okay, easy now. You're teaching a kid how to parallel park.
Lane closure ahead on I-75 North in 350 feet. You're still on the fastest route.
License plate holders and headlights. They've got lots of headlights. When you need parts, get it right the first time with eBay Guaranteed Fit. When you see the check, you know that part's going to fit. eBay Motors, let's ride. Eligible items only. Exclusions apply.
Without the ones like you, who work tirelessly to keep things running, everything would suddenly stop. Hospitals, factories, schools, and power plants, they all depend on you. No matter the weather, emergency, or time of day, you're the ones who get it done. At Grainger, we're here for you with professional-grade industrial supplies. Count on real-time product availability and fast delivery. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Hey, what's up, everybody? Ken Barkley here with a Sports Betting Minute brought to you by BetMGM, the king of sportsbooks. Tonight in pro basketball, I'll take the under in Oklahoma City and Phoenix, 233 in the market right now. It's been three games since Phoenix's big trade acquisition obviously made his debut, and the theme in all three games was exceptional defense. Only Dallas was able to score efficiently against them. Dallas is one of the best offenses in the league. So you've got Phoenix's improving defense and Oklahoma City on the second night of a back-to-back, resting their star player. Not really sure how they're scoring in this game. A blowout also very possible here, which helps the under. I'll take under 233.5. That's it for this Sports Betting Minute, brought to you by BetMGM. Download the BetMGM app and take your game to the next level with the king of sportsbooks.
Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. Must be 21 years of age or older to wager. Michigan only. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-270-7117 for confidential help. Experience Michigan disassociated persons.
Welcome to Allstate, where saving on your auto insurance is kind of like a joyride. You, your car, and an open road. Maybe your best friend, too. The music is chill, and so is the traffic. Allstate. Here, better protection costs a whole lot less. You're in good hands with Allstate.
Contact Michigan's Allstate agent, Cheryl Bowker, at 734-525-9610 or agents.allstate.com for a quote today.
Allstate and affiliates offer products and services subject to availability, terms, and conditions.
How about we break from this Michigan weather?
Let's head to the beach,
the Vegas Strip,
Music City,
the Arizona Red Rocks, and more.
FNT is your hometown airport.
It's where vacation, family time, and laughter starts.
Fly local and book your nonstop flight from Flint today at Allegiant.com.
97.1 The Ticket would like to remind you that when you text The Ticket, standard text messaging rates apply.
Let's just continue the football-a-palooza and do things non-Lamar for
be about money.
You don't get to say that.
No, I do.
I can't believe it.
It's whatever I say it is.
In football today.
So let's start with this. Lamar Jackson is debating. Oh, I'm sorry. Wrong story here. Let's move here to Aaron Rodgers. Fellas, it may be happening. Breaking news here. Aaron Rodgers has purchased an apartment in Upper West Side Manhattan.
Are you being for real?
I'm being for real. That's what's being reported.
Okay. I mean, he's a Jet. It's going to happen.
He went with the apartment, not the cave?
He went with... Yeah, it's not dark. It is an actual
darkness apartment. Chalet.
Where's the best cave, Emily?
Okay. In New York. He can live in the tunnel.
Yeah, exactly.
And can you get a slice delivered to that cave?
I'm sure. With the money he's going to be making, yes. I just want that deal to be done because him as a Jet is theater. It's perfect for what we do for a living. And he's out in the division. But we all believe he's a Jet. I mean, Woody Johnson, Salah, Joe Douglas, they all flew out there yesterday.
Yeah, when the plane went to the West Coast.
Yeah. It just feels like that's done. Now, what do you think Green Bay gets? 2 seconds?
No, I think if you're Green Bay, you'll settle for 2 seconds, but you probably went in there asking for a first.
But you're not getting a first.
But if you gave
but
me,
you asked.
If you gave me 2 seconds and a third, like, in a couple of years, okay.
Let's do this today. We're going to go through some wide receivers in the NFL, and there's a lot of rumors regarding wide receivers. Let's start with Brandon Cooks in Houston. Multiple reports say multiple teams have expressed interest in the veteran. He's tired of going 11-38-1 in his career in Houston. What would you trade for Brandon Cooks?
Just for the record, so teams are interested in a guy who's been passed around like communion bread and has concussion issues, but they're not interested in Lamar Jackson.
Multiple teams, yes.
Right. I want nothing to do with him.
Yeah, he's not going to cost you $250 million.
No, either. My point is he's quit on multiple teams. He has concussion problems. He's not a big wide receiver. And I just start to get worried when a guy, if you're so special, why are you on a new team every year? Patriots, Saints, he started with Texans. He started his career, New Orleans. Like, he went to L.A. for 10 minutes. I'm out.
David, to me, I feel like wide receivers the same way you and Mike feel about running backs. I'm not breaking the bank for them. It's a dime a dozen position. Every year there's going to be a bunch of guys who come out in the draft that you've never heard of and are going to light it up on the sideline. I mean, light it up on the field. Nothing.
Okay, well, I'm going to keep going up the list, and maybe we'll get to a wide receiver you're willing to trade for. Cortland Sutton for the Broncos is on the box. 64 receptions, 829 yards last year, 14 career touchdowns in his five-year career. What would you give up for Cortland Sutton?
Fourth round pick. Not interested. I was going to say a fifth, but
not productive.
He's gotten hurt. If I got 2 fourth round picks, sure, you could have the second.
Although I will say he could be a buy low because the QB play in Denver has been horrific, in a word. Fourth round pick for me.
Next receiver, Alan Lazard is a hot commodity, according to NBC Sports' Matthew Berry.
Yeah.
There are multiple teams, including the Chiefs and the Ravens, who are keen on him.
Wow.
What would you give up for him?
Well, the Ravens is a death sentence, so I don't like that for Alan. I like Alan Lazard. He's that big, physical, perimeter wide receiver. And I just have a value for that. Those guys, you can't teach the size. It's just irreplaceable. So, how old is Lazard now? 26, 27? I mean, to me, Rico, while David's looking that up, don't you feel like unless you're elite, you're never talking a first-round pick? It's always going to be something in the mid-rounds for a veteran.
I like him. I mean, once again, I'm going to have to take the Dave Chappelle route. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Oh, my Lord.
Alan Lazard is 27.
Fourth round pick.
Let's talk about this next receiver. Might be a reason why Kansas City may want Alan Lazard, because it says that Mecole Hardman, the Chiefs are going to let him walk. The market is expected to be somewhat strong for Hardman in free agency, reports say.
How? The guy can't walk.
He also can't walk, yes.
He's never healthy. Ever. For 3 straight years, all I've heard is how Mecole Hardman's going to blow up with the Chiefs. and it never happens.
And this was the year to do it, right?
Yeah. So once again, robust market for guy who's a human body cast, no market for Lamar. And you tell me the owners aren't good.
I don't think it's really a robust market.
David just said, what did he just say?
It says, reports say there's a robust market in free agency.
And David does not use words like robust in a laughing manner.
Yeah, we'll let the market play out.
And then
one last receiver to go over here, and it is Hopkins, DeAndre Hopkins. It says the Cardinals have ladders in place for the wide receiver. States a second round pick and a conditional pick.
Hard pass.
Now, based off of what he does on the field, that is one where, yes, on the field, yeah, I'd pay the price.
I
know what I'm getting with him.
Out, awful, awful locker room, don't want it, selfish, and gone.
You can have him. Aren't most good receivers?
I don't care. I don't want him. I've heard enough. I don't want him. Not from you. I'm saying I've heard enough about him. I don't. I'm out.
So this next story is
That's why I corrected myself. I know how that sounded.
This next story is for you, Rico, because I was reading a CBS Sports article, and it came up with bold trades that need to happen, and this trade involves your 49ers.
Ooh.
Kirk Cousins and the 49ers. The Vikings will be getting a third-round pick and a 2024 second-rounder. Are you willing to give that up for Kirk Cousins to be your quarterback?
Say that again.
The Vikings will get, so the 49ers will give the Vikings a third-round pick this year, second-round pick next year.
No.
Because here's the story. I'd rather go out and get a rental QB for the season and just wait on Brock Purdy to come back in 2 seasons and see what happens.
But the harder is Brock Purdy. He may not beat that.
He may not, David, but at least I saw him doing some stuff, okay? I'd go get a Teddy Bridgewater for a year and just roll the dice and see what happens. No, that's way too much for us.
So let's have a quick conversation real quick regarding the Las Vegas Raiders here in a quarterback situation. They are drafting at 7, so they're not close enough to get one of the top quarterbacks. And a rumor I've seen all offseason is that they may trade for Mac Jones. Aaron Rodgers is rumored to go there. Doesn't look like that's happening. Could you?
Yeah, I can.
Scale of 1 to 10, Mac Jones being traded to the Raiders?
You know what? I'll give it an 8. I never thought of it before, but I think his days in New England are done. There are times, honestly, teams like the Raiders make me believe that I could run a team better. And I'm nobody. I swear to you. The Raiders make you believe a fan could run a team. Like, what was the movie where Whoopi Goldberg coached the Knicks?
Eddie. Like, they are that movie where I could take a fan and they could not do worse than what Raiders management has done over basically the last 20 years. GM bot.
Yeah.
Just plug in numbers and Mac Jones. So you let Derek Carr go to trade for Mac Jones. That's the play. That's the plan.
You don't have to pay Jones.
He's familiar with Jones.
Okay.
I'm just saying, he's still under the rookie deal.
Right. That's super.
I can see it. I would put it at an 8 out of 10.
Trading with the Patriots is always a fruitful experience. But it makes sense for the Raiders, and it makes sense for everybody. You don't have a QB right now, and you're not going to break the bank.
Then let's close it out with this, and I'm doing this for Kenny. I want to help him out because there's a ton of Lions fans calling about Derrick Henry. Let's talk about his betting odds on points bet for his next landing spot. The Dolphins and the Bengals are tied for the favorite at plus 400. And then you have the Chiefs, Bills, Eagles coming in at plus 500. Bears, Broncos, Falcons, plus 800. Lions are at plus 1,000 with the Ravens.
Go ahead, Rick.
The best landing spot for Derrick Henry.
I mean, with the line, put them on the Eagles. And, man, it'll be pick your poison.
Miles Sanders is a free agent. So
is Boston Scott.
Correct.
I mean, I would probably say the Eagles.
I'll go Atlanta. I like Arthur Smith's running game. He's a former Tennessee OC. He designed that scheme that launched Henry's career.
And you give Desmond Ridder a running game.
Get Desmond Ridder the hell out of Atlanta and get a real QB in there.
But yes, I
Lamar. It's the match made in heaven, but Atlanta came out and went, no, we don't want herpes. I'm like, okay. Everyone is treating Lamar like an STD. It's unbelievable.
Don't know who really wants herpes, but
that's the point I'm making. Like, these teams that desperately need quarterbacks are treating him like he's poison.
David, I got one more for you before we wrap this
up. Yeah, real quick, yeah.
You guys remember the Michael Irvin story?
Yes.
Apparently, two gentlemen who were in the lobby in Phoenix have come out and said that Michael Irvin did nothing inappropriate. It was a brief encounter. They didn't see anything between the interaction with him and that room. So, just an update on that whole Michael Irvin story.
And remember, that's where he was sent home from NFL Network coverage. There was this big kerfuffle. He called into a radio show the next day. It was kind of chaotic, and then it went under the radar because the actual Super.
He's filed a $100 million defamation lawsuit against Jane Doe and Marriott International Hotel.
Good. I mean, you know, the accusations made, it damaged his reputation, it damaged his employment. Good. Sort of on court. Go ahead. What else?
That's the thing. You got two gentlemen who came out and was like, "Yeah, we saw the whole thing," and they put their names to it and said, "Yeah, that did not happen."
Yeah, something to pay attention to, and that is in football today.
You want to feel crazy? I see nothing wrong with it.
7-1-5
ticket. Traffic.
This report brought to you by NECA IBEW Local 58. Still have all the slowdowns as you make your way into the work zones, and there's now a crash and closure. US 23 northbound at Silver Lake Road and Whitmore Lake. Drivers are backed up from 8 Mile. You can exit early and take Whitmore Lake Road or Fieldcrest Drive instead. Put the expertise and skill of NECA signatory contractors and IBEW electricians to work on your commercial, public, industrial, or residential construction project. Productivity and innovation matter. Learn more at Powering Michigan. Future.com. I'm Michelle Pena with traffic.
Here comes the Sandman.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Meadow Sandman.
Stories of perseverance, accomplishment. Allstate desk. I'm Jeff Lesson. For more, 97.1theticket.com.
Just so you're not confused and not misleading listeners, that was one of the famous updates where Lesson was choking on the air. And he battled through, and we always save the audio. We don't talk. It was like Karsh and Crosstalk were dug in to walk out of here. What a sensation. I want David to hit the ticket text, and then we'll kind of update where we are. And yes, it's been... I'll continue to do the Lamar stuff, but I have to mix in the conversation about Arizona. I think there's news with Arizona at the 3 pick, and I want to at least get, for my own sanity, mix that in. So we'll do that. We'll get the Lamar calls. And if you want to know what the hell is a Lamar call, it's simple. You're the betting favorite to land Lamar Jackson at 3. You're the betting favorite. Why? I have no idea. But according to Chris Burke, BetOnline.ag, they're 3-1.
You always say Vegas knows.
Well, this is an overseas book, but yes, principle.
Monte Carlo knows.
That place does this.
It does.
Monaco. David, what do you have for us? You're smiling here.
Yeah, I am, because this one came in. No Lamar, because you don't pay running backs.
He's not. I don't care what you say. Well, he had a magical MVP. Great. What is he now? What is he in the here and now? What has he done in the playoffs? What does he do when the chips are down? You know what team was having big leads evaporate left and right this year? The Ravens. Why? He stunk. 20-point lead to Buffalo. 20-point lead to Miami. 17-point lead against the Giants. I don't want to hear it.
Everybody didn't have White Lightning on their team.
It's Vanilla Vic. Get it right.
Can Lamar play quarterback or edge? If not, I'll keep my picks. Offense is not the problem. Ryan from Detroit.
So let me ask this question. When I brought up the Arizona pick, Arizona today, look, the rumors are they want to move the number 3 pick. They need more picks. Okay. I've been saying for weeks, just call Arizona. Let's try to get to 3. Let's get Will Anderson and be done with this deal. I think there's an overwhelming chance the first and second picks are quarterbacks. I want Will Anderson. Now, again, this is about Brad Holmes. He may hate Will Anderson, and we don't know it. The point is, I view it, Will Anderson, that Von Miller speed rush guy on one end, Aiden, more of a balanced rusher, bigger kid on the other. You create a nightmare.
I like it because even if you don't like Will Anderson, what you've now done is you made yourself a player. Because if all of a sudden the QBs are flying off the board, now you may have a team who wants to all of a sudden reach up and say, hey, I want Anthony Richardson. I'll make the deal for you. And if you're the Lions, you get your picks back. So, yeah, you get your picks back plus some kicking
time. Right. Now, again, price certainty, right? I view it as if I give up pick 6 and a second round. On the trade chart, that gets me to 3. The point I'm making is, as much as I wouldn't want to do 6 and 18, I want to say, hey, if I'm Brad Holmes, let's say I view Will Anderson as the guy. I'm going to pay the price to get the guy. I don't want to let the market have me have to take someone else or not know what's going to happen. I want the certainty. See, the difference...
For a one and a two...
Sure. Right. The difference between the Lamar thing and a draft move of aggression is the opportunity cost is not the same. If I'm right, like, first of all, do you like Will Anderson the way I do?
I don't think anybody likes Will Anderson the way you do, Mike. But no, I
noted. Fair. That's very fair.
But yes, I look at, you can't go wrong with either Anderson or Carter.
Yeah. And again, if the legal aside, we have, 2 months until the draft. It'll sort.
Because the legal aside, you bring in a guy like Carter, you can go out and draft another edge rusher with a second or third round pick.
Right.
Yeah, okay. Now you got your defensive line set for the next 4 years.
My thing is, whoever Holmes likes more, go and get him. Don't wait. Don't let other teams get up there and do what they want to do. Go get the player. Price certain. And look, I'm not sitting here telling you we reinvented the wheel. We've been talking about Arizona for weeks because it doesn't make any sense for them to sit at three. They're rebuilding. They're blowing the thing up. Like
they want volume.
They want picks. Lottery tickets. They need something.
Quantity, not quality.
Right. Yeah. So for me, guys, look, we're setting up scenarios because the one non-negotiable for me, the Lions cannot have a boring offseason. Can't. I don't believe...
I think Lamar would qualify for not boring.
There's a sensible not boring. Like, being bold in the draft like they were with Jameson Williams, getting up, getting Will Anderson.
I like moving up. I would take Carter, and then I would double down and get Nolan Smith from Georgia.
Yes, whatever you want. My point is move up and take the best defensive guy. We're in agreement. Done. I'm not even arguing about it. Free agency. Go get Levante David. Or go get Bobby Okereke. You know, go get a legit linebacker, diverse skill set, smart, team captain type. Make that happen. Like, I cannot abide an offseason again where they're not active in free agency. I can't.
So you don't want to hear that we're just going to sign our own guys and go run it back again?
No, I don't. Because when you don't make the playoffs, you don't get to run it back. They're on the cusp of winning this division. They're on the cusp of making a run for a Super Bowl. How about we act like big boys and go do those things? You know what the Kansas City Chiefs did after they got their asses kicked in the Super Bowl? They didn't run it back. They got aggressive as hell to fix that offensive line.
Yeah, I feel sorry for Mahomes. Because that day... It was one He basically played the role of Zeke Elliott.
Yep. They acquired Orlando Brown Jr. They went out and drafted Creed Humphrey. They went out and signed Joe Tooney. They did what they needed to do.
Yeah.
Okay? That's what you need to do. So I think, look, I know the Lamar thing's fun. I understand people are into it. It's cool. We'll take the calls. I think the bigger storyline is the number three pick is open for business. And yeah, I've been saying it for weeks. Why would I change now? I'd call, and you know what, guys? I want to reinvest in Aiden Hutchinson. They made a big commitment taking him number two overall. Do you know what's going to help Aiden's success?
Somebody else.
Having a terror on the other side of the field. And then you turn James Houston into that situational pass rush guy. Preserve his snap count.
Because when you think about it, Aiden got better as the year went on when teams couldn't just double team him and take him out of the play. Now you had to watch out for you. You had to watch out for everybody on that line. And, yeah, if you now have that guy, got to pick your poison.
Especially with a guy. If you guys like Aiden, if you're a Michigan fan, just remember something. As good of a year as Aiden had at Michigan, when he got that fake invite to New York, Will Anderson had twice the year. Go look at the numbers. Go look at the tape. Will Anderson had the greatest defensive season in the history of college football. He did Alabama. Just don't forget that. Don't let facts get in the way of your fantasy. 248-539-9797. Did I miss anything? David, you want to keep it timely here? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, great. David, are you good?
Great.
Are you okay with the George Mason selection?
Yes. Yes, I am. Yes. All right.
They stopped calling fouls.
Championship week peak right here when you have an entire radio show watching George Mason Richmond, the 5-12 and the A-10 tournament. Fully invested.
No. You missed it while you were out watching the ponies. Because you see the excitement that was happening here?
Yes.
Except for it was the Women's Big Ten Tournament.
Congratulations.
So, yeah. We were hanging on every game and every bucket.
Beauty of betting.
Yes, it is. Yeah.
248-539-9797. Here's Rico.
Even a wager that misses can still be a slam dunk with BetMGM, the authorized gaming partner of the NBA. Let's say NBA one-game parlay wager with at least four legs or more, and if one of the legs misses, don't worry about it. You'll receive up to $25 back. Just opt into this promotion on the BetMGM app or on the website. With one-game parlay, you can make selections within a single NBA game from tons of bet types, including team and player props. Come on, you know, if you listen to me, I give you the winners. Opt into the promotion, then place an NBA one-game parlay wager with four legs or more. You get up to $25 back if you just miss out on one leg.
BetMGM and GameSense remind you to play responsibly and offer resources to help you make appropriate choices. Visit BetMGM.com for terms and conditions. You must be 21 years of age or older to wager. This is Michigan only. All promotions are subject to qualification and eligibility requirements. Rewards issued as non-withdrawable bonus bets, and those bonus bets will expire in 7 days from being issued. Gambling problem? Call 1-800-270-7117 for confidential help. Excludes Michigan disassociated persons.
Spring is in the air at the Progressive Novi Boat Show. Find your adventure. Fishing, cruising, water sports, shop nautical decor and apparel at Harborside Market, March 9th through 12th. Suburban Collection Showplace, NoviBoatShow.net. Time is better with a
boat. Snoop Dogg presents
Legendary. It's brought to you by the D-O-double-G.
High School Reunion Tour with Wiz Khalifa, Too Short, Warren G, Burner, and special guest DJ Drama. Snoop Dogg, Wiz Khalifa, and friends live in concert. Buy now, Music Theater, July 23rd. Get tickets this Friday at 9 a.m. at LiveNation.com.
Hi,
who's this?
Buzz, he appears whenever you eat Honey Nut Cheerios.
Like a genie?
Sure.
Ooh, does he grant wishes? I wish I lived in a giant boot. No, I wish I could swim with a humpback whale. No.
I can grant you a delicious bowl of Honey Nut Cheerios, which can help lower cholesterol as part of a heart-healthy diet.
Ooh, with heart shapes, too.
Happy Heart-Shaped Cheerios are back for a limited time. Pick up a box of Honey Nut Cheerios at your local store for an easy, delicious, and heart-healthy start to your day.
People who come to Cricket stay with Cricket, just like our customer, Michelle. As an entrepreneur, every day is different. My phone bill from Cricket, on the other hand, always stays the same. Without surprises, hidden fees, or annual contracts, I can work worry-free. That's Michelle, everybody, doing business like a boss. Smile, you're on Cricket.
Real customer, pay for testimonial. See CricketWireless.com for details.
I switched to Boost Mobile and got a free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone. Want to know the best part?
It was free.
Nope.
The fact that it's on America's largest 5G networks?
Nope. It's the ding.
Oh, yeah. Love the ding.
Right? It's all about the ding. It's the dingarooski. The dingarooner. Ring-a-ding-ding.
Unleash your power to save with Boost. Get a free Samsung Galaxy A23 5G phone when you switch. Boost Mobile. Unleash your power.
And the ding.
Limited time offer. New customers only. Available on select networks. 5G not available everywhere. One device per line. Tax excluded. Additional restrictions apply. See your local Boost Mobile store for details.
Tonight, partly cloudy, low of 28.
Weather brought to you by Total Wine & More. At Total Wine & More, save big on what you love this month with hundreds of deals on amazing wines and spirits. Love what you find at the lowest prices only at Total Wine & More. Drink responsibly. B21.
Let your voice be heard. Call the D Las Vegas 97.1 The Ticket Studio Line at 248-539-9797. The D Las Vegas, the home for Detroit sports in Vegas.
Hi, this is Dan DiBardino. Crime Stoppers of Michigan continues to work with crime victims, their families, and over 200 law enforcement agencies, providing both our 1-800-SPEAK-UP anonymous tip line, as well as providing safety information to our Center for Crime Prevention. We again need your help. Please consider joining our $5 a month club through our website, 1-800-SPEAK-UP.org. On behalf of all those we serve, thanks to the many who have already joined this program, joining us in keeping Southeast Michigan safe for all of us.
All right, there's Kenny with a finger point, which means it's time for me to tell you about David Femininio, somebody you can talk to about your auto accident and injury. It is David Femininio at GetDavidGetPaid.com. When you call, the consultation is free. You don't take a fee until you get paid. That's why when you're injured in Michigan, you get David, you get paid. Simple. Call him up 24-7, 855-65-CRASH. He will answer. Hit the website as well at GetDavidGetPaid.com.